Thank you very much, Chris, and thank you all for coming. In designing my program for today, I've taken my cue from the fact that we're in the new year. As a whole, the program explores the nature of time. We begin with two chorales from J.S. Bach's Little Organ Book. In Dir ist Freude is a chorale sung at New Year, and Bach's prelude creates a sense of rejuvenation and joy through the imitation of pealing bells. The theme of bells, incidentally, returns at the end of the program in Duruflé's Fugue on the Carillon of Soissons Cathedral. The second chorale prelude by Bach, Das alte Jahr, vergangen ist, denotes the end of the old year. Why then is it placed after In Dir ist Freude? The program order seems eccentric. My purpose is to open up novel ways of thinking about time. Does time pass linearly? Does it always move from A to B to C, etc.? Or does it go A to B, then back to A, or something else? These questions are very relevant to the third item, the canon from Bach's musical offering. You have the music printed on your program. This is one of several canons that Bach wrote based upon a musical theme provided by Frederick the Great of Prussia. What is not immediately obvious is that this is a perpetual canon which moves continually upwards through the keys. We hear the same music several times, but at different pitch levels. Yet in moving upward, the canon is looped and as such creates a cyclical effect. Yet in moving upwards through the keys, it also moves in a linear fashion. It has no ending. You have to decide where to stop. The Estonian composer Arvo Pärt is known for his mesmeric music. If you're familiar with ethereal pieces such as Spiegel im Spiegel and Cantus in Memoriam Benjamin Britten, then you may be surprised by what you hear today. On the surface, Annum per Annum has an almost twee quality in places. Ultimately, though, the impression made is contemplative. Annum per Annum is structured as a mass. The letters K, G, C, S, and A stand for the mass movements, Kyrie, Gloria, Credo, Sanctus, and Agnus Dei. The Mass has been celebrated since the early years of Christianity. Today we might consider the question, what is the meaning of this worship tradition spanning two millennia? Without wishing to detract from the drama of the piece, I should warn you that near the beginning, Arvo Pärt asks the player to turn the organ off. So don't be alarmed, there hasn't been a power cut. So on to the Messiaen. Olivier Messiaen stands as a top rank composer of the 20th century. Like the music of Pärt, Messiaen's music has a mesmeric quality. Much of it evokes a sense of eternity. Apparition of the Eternal Church is a case in point. It explores the theological idea that God's church, though it exists in the context of earthly linear time, is eternal. Thus, this music seems to acknowledge God as a figure who exists beyond earthly time. In God's time, perhaps, there's no distinction between past, present, and future. Duruflé's fugue transports us back to where we began with the sound of church bells. Thank you very much for coming, and I hope you enjoy the program.
Thank you. Thank you.